Hi, I'm Grant Williams. I specialize in pavement management for Clackamas County. Come take a ride with me and I'll show you some projects that we can do with some of the Clackamas funding for Clackamas roads. So we're getting into a rural local road now. Typically, these are your roads that your house is going to be connected to. This road was chip sealed. One of the reasons why this road was chip sealed is because, like a lot of our roads, it started getting a lot of cracking. We want to seal those cracks up. We've got areas that you'll see on these roads that have edge cracking. Edge cracking can get to be an issue if you're passing by another vehicle and your tires are near the edge of the road and you've got some drop-offs that can become a safety hazard. A lot of what we do when we look at the roads is not just keeping the condition of the road good. We all want good roads, but there's also a safety factor in all of it. We want to keep the roads safe for the motoring public. Local roads in the pavement management program, the software piece that we use, locals don't rank very high in the system. And the reason they don't is because they're smaller, low volume, local neighborhood type streets. The demand, most of the demand is on our arterials and collectors. They've got more cars, more traffic, more trucks, so they deteriorate at a faster rate. So what the system looks at when it ranks these roads is it looks at a cost to benefit analysis. It knows that if an arterial or collector deteriorates to a point where you've got to do some major rehab work to it, it's going to be very, very cost prohibitive. So it tries to keep good roads good, do the right road, the right treatment at the right time. So when you think about locals, think about neighborhood streets, residential streets. We have a whole bunch of urban roads that are just like this, that it's rough. This road is extremely rough, and it's because the asphalt's fatigued in areas, it's settled in areas, and we obviously can't pave over this. If we just paved over this, it would show back up within a year or two. The other thing that we'll run into sometimes on our urban streets and our rural streets is you'll have a problem with root heave. You know, you'll get roots that grow out from the trees under the road and they'll heave up the road. Those can be challenging in the fact that you can grind the raised asphalt that's humped up from the roots shoving it up. But if you don't address the roots underneath it, we all know that trees continue to grow, as do roots. It's going to continue to do the same thing. Streets like this here, typically, as we've traditionally done, it would be packaged as we do an arterial or a collector in the area. Vehicle registration fee will allow us to come out and address roads like this to try to bring them up to a condition that's acceptable from a safety standpoint as well as from a keeping the road in good condition standpoint. It'll allow us to address roads that right now we don't have the budget to address. We are one of the only local agencies in the area that doesn't have a local funding source for our roads to supplement the gas tax. However, we're the largest paved road miles county within the state of Oregon. You want your street in front of your house paved. You want nice roads. Everyone wants nice roads to travel on. I think the challenge is in realizing that local municipalities, the state, the feds, everybody across this country, we're all in the same boat. Our roads were always funded by gas tax. And as you get cars out here that are more and more fuel efficient, it's less and less revenue because the cars are going further and further and further on less fuel. Look how many more roads have been built and how large our infrastructure is across this country. It's a challenge. I mean, we all want new roads, but the challenge is how do we pay for it and how do we accomplish the goal that we all want?